Hey everybody, Dave here, Hidden Freedom Investing. In today's video, we're gonna go my dividend portfolio update for the month of March. We're gonna look at all the buys, the sells. We're gonna look at all the dividends received. And this was a record-breaking month for me for dividends received. In addition, also the account hit a record high as well. So let's go ahead and not waste any time. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, we're looking at the dividend portfolio overview page here, and it's kind of just start off from the left here. So total value, this is two accounts represented here, and total value right now, $462,564. Annual dividend income is $18,165. Monthly dividend income is $1,514. Daily income, daily dividend income is $50 roughly, and hourly dividend income is $2.07. The account weighted dividend yield is 4.13%. Account yield on cost is roughly 4.74%. Average weighted 5-year dividend CAGR is 6.94%. Average weighted beta 0.86. And the average beta is 0.75. Number of positions still 28. And number of shares 7248. Right now, this dividend portfolio is up unrealized $56,792, which is 14.8% return. And coming down here, we have $462,000 of the $1 million goal that we have set. That means it leaves $537,000 remaining. So we're 46% to the goal. Right now there is free cash in here. We're gonna talk about that here in a second, but there is $22,500 in cash in my taxable account. And that basically went into the account today. I just didn't have a chance to buy anything today. The market was up, so I just decided not to buy anything. But we'll talk about where that cash came from and I guess the plan going forward. So you just saw Dividend Mountain there, and there was a little bit of progress on Dividend Mountain. So looks like we're heading towards that $500,000 mark. Hope to hit that by the end of April. So that should be pretty easy to do if the market can cooperate with us. Well, I guess we'll see. I mean, I can add more cash to the account, but you know, I kind of want to have some market return, plus maybe add some more cash. But anyways, let's go ahead, and this is the agenda for the month of April. So let's go ahead and look at the 2A here. So all day spreadsheets are available. See pinned comment or description. Did not do any updates for the month of March there. And so if you're interested in any of my spreadsheets, go ahead and see that first pinned comment there. That moves us to 2B here, real estate notes paid back. And let's see, I did have one real estate note got paid back. It was basically the end of March. You know, I got out of the blue, literally. You know, I got a payoff demand request for one of the notes I was in. And I was pretty surprised because I had just recently looked all the houses to see if they were for sale, and the house was for sale, and this one wasn't either. So I'm assuming that guy probably sold the house to maybe the person he was renting it to. So, because it didn't go on the market at all, but I was, you know, pretty pleasantly surprised to find out that a note was going to get paid back, and there were $3,000 in prepayment penalties because they paid the loan off about 7-8 months early. And that was pretty cool. So I got $74,812 in total received from that note being paid back. And I put $22,500 in the dividend portfolio, which we just looked at there. And the rest, $41,000, not quite the rest, but the, you know, I put $41,000 in options trading account. And then about $3,300 or so went in towards taxes because the prepayment penalty counts as interest. So that will go towards interest. Not all of it's actually gonna get, you know, go towards taxes, but I'm so deficient in the amount of money I'm setting aside for taxes, I just decided to put the whole amount towards taxes. And then that brings us down to C here, which is roughly $457,000 left in real estate notes. And that's down from 530 last month because of that note that just got paid back. If you're not familiar with what real estate notes are, I've done one video on that, and it's a promissory note video, which I'll go ahead and link up here if you're interested. And there's still, I think, about 6 notes left to get paid back, 2 on the tax deferred side, and then the 4 on the taxable side. So that is coming down. So that brings us to 2D here. If you didn't see my last video, I did start a second channel called Hidden Off Grid, and that's just to talk about my life after FIRE, financial independence, retire early, and you know, all the kind of events leading up to that, all the planning things that go on this year, because I'm going to FIRE next year in 2022. So there's a lot of stuff to get done. So I did start that channel there because a lot of that stuff is not finance related. So if you're interested in seeing that channel or going to support me on that channel, please see the first pinned comment there, and I'll put a link down there for you. And I would really appreciate it if you would support that channel if you're interested in following that journey. We talk about a lot of different things outside of investing. So that brings us down here to 3. So 3A, dividend increases. Let's go ahead and look at the dividend increases here. I think there's a couple. I already took a look. So let's see dividends. Let's go to current portfolio. So these are all the positions in my dividend portfolio. And you know, you could pause this video if you want, but I did do an update video talking about all the positions in my dividend portfolio. If you want to take a look at that video, look at it up here. And I went through all the positions one by one in that video because it looked like people were pausing the video every time I show my portfolio. So let's go and scroll to the right here and look at the dividend increases. And let's see here, I think we have a couple in here. So here's a couple right here. The first one we're gonna go over is Colgate-Palmolive. Looks like it had a 2.27% increase, and that is actually, you know, pretty much right in line. It's a little bit lower than what we'd expect, but that's not bad. That's actually, you know, pretty close. So I'm pretty happy with that. You know, it's a dividend increase, keeps them in line. They are a dividend king, and 58 years of consecutive dividend increases, I believe. So that's keeping that streak alive. Let's go ahead and scroll right here and go ahead and clear that flag. So we'll go ahead and set it to $1.80, and that should clear the flag. And let's go ahead. Looks like we got another dividend increase here on Realty Income. That is a monthly payer. And we had a 0.21% increase, which is not a lot, but I think they do multiple increases every single year. So this is the first one of the year, I believe, and it brought it to 0.235 from 0.2345, I think. And you know, I mean, we really can't calculate if that is in line or not because they normally do multiple per year. So, you know, by the time the end of the year comes, we'll have to add them all up and then see if it's kind of in line where it shows what the 1 year dividend CAGR is and the 5 year dividend CAGR and all that. So let's go ahead and clear that flag there. So it's 2.82, and I believe that should increase their consecutive years. I don't know if it's 28 or not. It should be very close to that. Might be 27, but I have to double check, but I know there are a dividend aristocrat for a fact. So, you know, at least they're over 25. So let's go ahead and see if there's any more here. And it looks like we do have another one here on VYM. And obviously this one really doesn't count because that one's, you know, the dividend is all over the place on VYM, including NUSI as well. But I'm just kind of looking at what the latest reported dividend was on FinViz. And when I input that, we got a dividend increase of about 4%. And that actually is not quite in line, but I know that they basically had an issue with their dividend last year because a lot of stocks in VYM cut their dividend, and that did lower the 5 year CAGR from like 9% down to 7%. But it is what it is, so we just keep track of that one every month. We adjust it as needed. So let's go ahead and clear that flag there. It's 3.11, and that clears that flag. And there is no more other dividend increases at this time. So let's go ahead and look at the agenda here. So let's go and look at 3B here, the sells for the month of March. And here are the sells for the month of March. I did render some profits. So we took a little bit of profits in T, took a little bit of profits in Caterpillar. We took a little profits in Duke there, took a little profits in ExxonMobil, a little bit of profits on Southern, a little bit of profits on Starbucks, and a little bit of profits in VYM. So a total profits of what, $2,680 for short term, and you know, total, I had a little bit of long term loss there, but there was a little bit of wash sale on ExxonMobil because I a little bit made a mistake there. I sold 20 shares, but I really only wanted to sell 10, so I ended up buying 10 back, which we'll see that here in a second. So those are the sells that I'd made for the month of March. So all that stuff that I sold just there in Schwab all went into NUSI there. So I had rendered about $21,488 and that all went into NUSI, bought 798 shares of NUSI. And then there's that mistake that I made. I sold 20 shares of ExxonMobil by mistake and then I bought 10 shares back. And so the total spend really was about $21,488. This is a record-breaking dividend month for me. Go ahead and like and subscribe and hit that bell notification. So this is the current allocation as it stands. I should actually probably update this over here. It's the end of March. We got a whole nother quarter in the book, so I'll go ahead and update that by the next time the video comes out. And this is the dividend portfolio allocation for individual stocks. And right now, consumer staples at 22%, utilities at 8.2, financials 6.1, healthcare at 13.9, materials at 1.9, real estate at 4%, energy at 4.7, industrials at 8, consumer discretionary 8.8, communication services 6.4, and information technology at 15.8. So this is the allocation for the VU, S&P 500 ETF from Vanguard. So I try to keep it pretty close to that. Obviously it's not exact. Utilities, I'm kind of running hot on utilities, but those are kind of defensive and act more like bonds in a way. Materials, I think there's just one stock in there, APD. And then industrials, 8%, there's only one stock in there and that's Caterpillar. And then I think real estate, there's just Realty Income. Energy is only two stocks, Chevron and ExxonMobil. And information technology at this time is really only Apple and Microsoft. So that's where the allocation stands at this time. Here we are looking at the dividends received the month of March. And this was a record-breaking month for me. So $2,585 I received total. And received a dividend from Intel. We received a dividend from Pfizer, Starbucks, Southern, Johnson & Johnson, Chevron, ExxonMobil, IBM, Microsoft, 3M, McDonald's, Realty Income, Con Ed, Duke, Home Depot, VYM, NUSI, and Pepsi, which we just received today. Couple things to note here, VYM that pays quarterly, by the way. That is my dividend Vanguard ETF, $652. And we also have our monthly payer here from NUSI. So that's $663 received from NUSI. That is a monthly payer, just like Realty Income is a monthly payer as well, which I received $34 from Realty Income. So it's time to update the spreadsheet with all the dividends received for the month of March. So we'll go ahead and run a script here to update the month of March for all the dividends received across this line right here. So let's go ahead and do that now. We'll bring up the dividendometer for 2021. We'll bring up the script. Here is the script right here. We'll make this a little bit smaller. That's what she said, of course. And let's go ahead and kick that off.
Fat guy in a little coat.
Okay, dividends have been updated. So you saw the dividend meter go up. So we updated this, we ran the script, updated the portfolio Google Sheets to 2,585. So we'll go ahead and double check that. And let's go back to dividends received here. So we wrote all those dividends across that line right there and we should have 2,085 and we do. So it looks good. We saw the dividendometer go up there. So there we are, there's the dividendometer and we're at $4,116 and that's year to date. So scrolling down here, it looks like we have, we got one quarter in the books finally for 2021 and we eclipsed February with this ginormous March. And we got $2,585. Last month was $1,184. The month before that was $346. And because we added quite a bit of cash to NUSI, it looks like every month should be over $1,000 at this point on average. But we'll look at that here near the end of the video. Scrolling down here, this is dividends by quarter. So this actually closes out Q1 for 2021. And look at that, we dwarf 2019 and we dwarf 2020. Over 4,000 received for the quarter of Q1 of 2021. Dividends by year here. This is last year we received $7,248. And like I said, 2019 really wasn't even a dividend paying year for me, but I did have some dividend paying stocks in 2019, and we kind of started the portfolio in 2020, and then we're on track to basically almost, maybe we can actually triple this year. I don't know, we'll see. If I can get to 21,000 this year, that would be great, but right now we're slated to be about 18,000 this year. And then there's the dividends by ticker if you just want to pause the video and look at that. Okay, so we looked at all the metrics for the dividends received. Let's just talk about the options income here real quick. And looks like we had my IB account, which I do a lot of options trading there, mostly just cash secured puts. I did recover this month from a lousy end of February, which rolled into March. And then the beginning of March kind of ran into some issues. And just March in general, we've had issues in the market, especially in the NASDAQ, and that made it tough to make quite a bit of capital out of that account. But I did close the month out 25.40 positive. So that's a far cry from the 6,000 I made in January, and that's also a far cry from what the 6,000 I made in February. But I am up over $15,000 for the year, and that closes out the Q1. If I can make $15,000 every quarter the rest of the year, that would put me at $60,000 of options income for the year, which is incredible. I did have a couple of Schwab covered calls, and I did close out my VYMs. So I made $74 out of VYMs and one Apple, and I haven't really opened any new covered calls in the Schwab account. And I've kind of, abandoned the whole VYM covered call thing. It just hasn't worked in my favor. Over the last few months, every time it just goes in the money, and then it just makes me have to take a loss. And the last thing we're gonna do here is, let me see, we're gonna have the swap positions because somebody called me out and said, show your real account, don't show the spreadsheet. So I'm gonna make that part of every update video. And then the last thing we'll do is we'll look at the dividend projections for the month of April and see where we sit for what we're gonna receive for April. So logged into Schwab here. Here is all of the positions for my Schwab account. Like I said in the past, this is representative of two different accounts there. We got a little arrow there. If I click on that, that will actually show each position for the taxable account and the tax deferred account. But I'm not gonna click on that because there's a bunch of account numbers in there, so I'm not gonna show that. But this is representative of both accounts combined, which I actually show in my Google spreadsheet as well. These numbers should match up with what I have in my Google spreadsheet. So if you want to just, pause the video and look at that, or go back or something and look at that, it is what it is. If we scroll down here, here are the two ETFs I have in my dividend portfolio. So there's VYM, there's NUSI, 3,840 shares of NUSI at this time. And then we got no more options in this account at this time. You normally have some options down here, but leave your thoughts in a comment below on me adding Jeopardy to the portfolio. Go ahead and like and subscribe and hit that bell notification. Here is the dividend projections, and we'll have to click on next 12 months here, but here's March right here. We received everything, that $78. So we did receive that last dividend today, which is not counted in there yet, which was on Pepsi. But that should bring us to 2580 something or whatever that amount was, 2580 something. So let's go and click on the next 12 months here. And that's looking at May, April. Actually, we need to go back to April. So let's go ahead and go to 2021. Here's April right here. So we're looking at still making about $1,021 in April. Like I said, the average now is over $1,000 a month. So if we click on next 12 months here, and we got an average monthly income of $1,510. So looks like every single month should be over $1,000 at this time. So that's $1,000, that's $1,000. Yeah, so every month is gonna be over $1,000. And then we got another pretty big month there for June of $2,300. I do plan on adding that capital at $22,500 to the portfolio. It's already in as a cash. It hasn't showed up in the account. It should show up tonight, but I'm not really sure we're gonna actually invest that money. I'm gonna probably put a lot of that in a NUSI. I'm also looking at possibly adding Jeppy to this portfolio. I don't know if Jeppy meets all the requirements that I want. It meets two of them, but the third requirement it might not meet. And there's some little bit of tax funky stuff with Jeppy and NUSI possibly that I need to kind of get clarification on before I maybe add Jeppy, but who knows, it may show up in there. Maybe I'll invest in Jeppy tomorrow or next week or something like that. Maybe the next update video, maybe Jeppy will be in the portfolio. But what I like about Jeppy is invested, or it's against the S&P 500 stocks, which I like, and NUSI is against the QQQ, so I have kind of coverage there in both cases. And I kind of like that about JEPI. I do like that it's a monthly payer as well, but although that is not a requirement for me. So anyways, I think that's it for this video. If you have any comments, questions, or concerns, go ahead and leave a comment below. Hit me up on Facegram, Twitter. Shoot me an email if you want. Go ahead and leave a comment below if you would like as well. Until next time, go ahead and like and subscribe. We'll see you next video. Thanks for watching.